Hello guys, it is Leszek from Restro Cooking Channel, and today I'm going to cook very nice beef macaroni from Liechtenstein recipe, but in slow cooker. Actually it is Pressure King Pro pressure cooker, but I will be using it as slow cooker. It is my first time when I'm cooking in this pressure slow cooker as slow cooker, and it is good test for it. It's very simple recipe as usual. I like simple recipes, and I think that key is good beef. I'm in Scotland, so Aberdeen Angus beef is available for me. So I'm using this in my recipe. And first, what we need to do, we need saute the meat. It is because we want nice flavor of the beef inside the sauce. If we put everything into slow cooker, we'll be fine, we'll be working, but we lost a lot of flavor. So what I'm doing now, I'm not going to cook it now. I just want to get this little bit brown, and this is exactly what we want, this nice flavor, little bit burnt flavor from the meat. So I'm putting maybe just part of the meat, because if I put all, start cooking, not searing. In this pressure cooker, option for this is brown, meat brown. So I'm going to do this in three, four steps. And how we can see, at the bottom of the pan start be nice brown from the meat. Two red onions. Just slice it. Don't have to be red onion, can be white onions as well, but because it is beef, I will be cooking it in red wine. So red onion is good. So yeah, first part is ready. It's not cooked, it's raw inside, but you can see nice brown brown sauce start beyond the pan. You can of course prepare everything before cooking, but because the meat takes some time, I like to slice the vegetables during the cooking. It's just saving the time. Little bit more olive oil. So yeah, how I say this, very good test for Pressure King Pro. I like this pressure cooker because it's small and I don't have to put too much ingredients. What is good, if I just cooking for myself, And what is good, another thing that I can use this as pan. Of course, it's no problem to use separate pan for browning the meat. However, it's easier. It's less dishes for washing. So 3 carrots. We need to dice it. The ingredients are very important. So use good ingredients, the carrots, organic carrots, if you can't, organics, onions as well. This one is not organic, but is a good quality too. And beef, of course, even pasta should be good quality, because it's very difficult to cook something good using cheap, low quality ingredients. Yeah, so this meat is almost ready. Just a little bit more olive oil. Very nice flavor. This what you can think that something stick into the pan is actually what we want. It move your dish into next level. It's big difference if you just put everything together, how you can see on many adverts of pressure cookers or slow cookers. Yes, it is working, but it is not the same. Little bit more work and more time, and you have completely different dish. Of course, everything depends what you like, but I think that most people will see the difference. So now I want to saute the onion. When I'm putting this onion into the pot, all of this nice flavor from the beef is going to the onion, because when onion is searing, is adding water into the pot. Water is going from the onion and taking all the flavor from the bottom of the pot. You can see now you will see how it is working. So add the carrot. Yeah, it is what we want. So now I'm going to saute for another few minutes, and then I'm adding red wine. I speed up a little bit the video, because you don't want to see how it is cooking, but you can see it's nice cooked onion is nice soft, and now it's time for wine. Regarding wine, what kind of wine? It's actually should be full boiled, and this is what you want to drink. It's very simple rule for it. Don't use very expensive, but don't use cheap what you want, you will not want to drink. So everything what you like to drink and is not too much expensive is good for cooking. So now it's time for rest of ingredients, garlic, 3 cloves of garlic, finely chopped. I'm talking about this many times, but how you can see, your knife is your the best friend in the kitchen. It's very important to have good knife. Don't has to be the most expensive knife, but this one cost me about 60 pounds, but it's very nice. It's actually my favorite knife. I have few different what I'm using, but this is, I think this is the best. And how you can see, it even looks heavy, and it is heavy. You can slice garlic very finely without the problems. Okay, back the meat. Add chicken stock. I'm using cubed chicken stock. I'm doing this because I like taste of this ingredients inside the cube, but if you want, you can just use home cook chicken stock. For this dish it is okay. Some dishes like risotto required pure chicken stock, but this is easier. So about half cinnamon stick and salt and pepper. About 1 teaspoon of black peppercorns. This is how you like. I like quite a lot, but probably half teaspoon will be good as well. This adds nice taste and will be a little bit spicy. One bay leaf and add about 3 teaspoons of tomato paste. I've had too big, but just 3 teaspoons will be fine. And a little bit salt. I'm not adding too much because the stock was salty. And you can always check if it is salty, if not later on. It is slow cooker, not pressure cooker, so you can just open and taste. Because I'm using first time this slow cooker option, I have to check temperature and meat if it is tender. Then adjust the time. So let's check after about 1 hour. Oh, looks like temperature is very high. That's mean it's not very good for slow cooking. And how you can see, it is almost 100 degrees. So I'm going to cook for maybe another 1 hour because meat is not tender yet, and that's it. So slow cooker option in this pressure cooker is not the best, unfortunately. So after about 2 hours, you have to check if meat is tender. You need to add penne. So add how much you want. I like a lot of penne, a lot of pasta with the sauce, but if you want to have less pasta and more sauce, just add less. Yeah, so even it is not a very good slow cooker. Actually, it is not slow cooker. It is like pan. So one advantage is that you don't have to look at this. You can just left for 2 hours, and when you back, will be cooked. Is that not ideal? But it's fine. Comparing to a traditional pan, you have to always look at this and be in the kitchen. Here you can just go watch TV and back after 2 hours, and the dish will be done. Looks very nice, and hopefully will taste very nice as well. To be honest, I have two slow cookers, and both are not keeping temperature. Proper temperature for slow cooker is about 67 degrees Celsius. Okay, so let's taste it. Looks very nice. Smells very nice, and it's very good. The meat is tender, it's a little bit sweet, but a little bit spicy, very nice. So thanks a lot for watching, and I'm going to eat this.